My money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble, you know, riding in my Fiat. You really have to see it, 6'2" in a compact, no slack, but luckily...
Hello everyone, my name's Dean, let's talk crypto. This is where you subscribe for daily Bitcoin updates and technical analysis. We track the rise of Bitcoin as a proxy for the cryptocurrency markets at large. Today is February 25th, 2023. And yesterday's Bitcoin correction was a sign of strength. I do not just mean that figuratively. I also mean that literally. All right. I'm going to explain that and more in this video. Please like, share, and subscribe if you're not already. And let's get into it. So for those of you familiar with Wyckoff analysis, there is such a thing as an SOS, okay? An SOS is a sign of strength, and you typically see it after an accumulation is completed, okay? An accumulation is completed, and right before price leaves the channel of accumulation, it performs this SOS or sign of strength to gather momentum to leave the barriers of the previous resistance that it was accumulating in, okay? So just like men and women are really measured in times of turmoil and stress and strain and great challenge, as so a savvy investor measures the veracity of a trend by its correction, okay? We always say on this channel, it's not whether or not you made a higher low. That's what amateur speculators, amateur analysts do. That's as far as they get. The savvy investor looks for the retest. You don't buy the breakout, you buy the retest, okay? You don't sell the breakout, you sell the retest. You wait for that confirmation, okay? So here, we look and say, that Bitcoin has been in a bull run, okay? That is our thesis. Bitcoin has been in a bull run since January 1st. And so we'll only know the veracity, the true nature of this uptrend by what it does when it actually goes against the trend, okay? We use the counter trend to disambiguate the trend and vice versa. So here we have a counter trend and it did indeed bounce off of resistance, old resistance, making it new support, that 456 day downtrend, okay? And now we have another opportunity to show strength. That's what a sign of strength means. We're going to get more into that in a second, okay? But here, you make a higher high, and you come all the way down to the bottom of this 36-day channel, and you hold support, okay? This is what is meant by a sign of strength. This is how you both matriculate upwards, making higher highs and higher lows, right? You continue your uptrend, but at the same time, you accumulate, okay? In Elliott Wave Theory, we call this a leading diagonal, okay? I talked about that during the live stream. I went into the particulars of what I think a leading diagonal is. It's really a double zigzag, but whatever. We're not going to get into that here. Now, when you're talking about sign of strength, and guys, I do welcome you. Please do your own research. Don't just take my word for it. You have the internet just as I do. Go and research Wyckoff analysis, okay? It's useful, even though you're not a Wyckoff trader. Look at the accumulation schematic. It's uncanny, okay? You can see how we talk about 2 degrees of A-B basing and a pivot in Elliott Wave Theory. Here, Wyckoff presents 5 phases of an accumulation schematic, and that SOS that we're just now seeing in Bitcoin, right, leaving this accumulation range, retesting old resistances as new support, and finally breaking free, okay? But even in the Wyckoff schematic, you can see that the actual trend starts at the spring. The trend doesn't start once you leave the channel, but... I digress, you know. When we say the bull market started January 1st, that's the same thing. And again, look at this channel that we've been in. It's uncanny, the resemblance that it has to that Wyckoff accumulation schematic. You have your spring. You have your sign of strength. You have that all 5 phases of the Wyckoff accumulation. I'm going to have you look at it again, briefly. Look at the spring, look at the SOS, look at the progression, the matriculation through the old resistances up and out of the channel. This is what we're getting. This is why so many people are confused. Indicator traders, I call them, who over-reliant on indicators, do not have confidence in their ability to read price action, will not be able to gauge what's going on because their indicators cannot really grab the context of the move, okay? Even indicators have to be interpreted. So at the end of the day, you can't cheat the process. At the end of the day, if your indicators tell you this or that, you won't be able to know that this indeed is a sign of strength. It is a continuation of this trend, and it's not a distribution. It's not a rejection of the trend, okay? And the other thing we always say on this channel is you want to be careful when you're consolidating at resistance. There's one thing, rejecting at resistance. That's bearish. But when you consolidate at resistance, that's bullish. This is what we're getting. Finally, when you're looking at the Wyckoff accumulation, look at what Wyckoff describes the accumulation of strength as, okay? And I have it right here. The SOS sign of strength is a price advance on increasing spread and relatively higher volume. Often an SOS takes place after a spring, validating the analyst's interpretation of that prior action. Okay, so we go back to our Bitcoin price and we have our volume. And what do you see? Since January 1st, we have a marked increase in volume, just as Wyckoff postulated, okay? You don't see me use volume that much on this channel, only because, you know, there's so many different exchanges in crypto, so many different low cap assets that volume isn't all it's crapped up to be. It really depends on where you're looking at the volume. So I'm not using volume that much, but I just want to make the point that you are seeing an increase in volume while the price increases. That is volume convergent. This is what you want to see in a tried and true trend. All right, moving forward, let's dive in to the smaller time frames. All right, because a lot of people don't really see this as a veritable bounce. Okay, when we look at Bitcoin on the smaller time frame, now let's get rid of our volume. We no longer need it. And guys, again, if you're getting value, please like, share, and subscribe. You can see very clearly that you're putting in a very nice version of the Wyckoff accumulation channel here, okay? These things are fractal. Just like I always talk about 2 degrees of baby basing on the channel, the same thing for this Wyckoff accumulation schematic. It doesn't matter, it's time frame agnostic. So price came down all of 5% and all kinds of people came out of the woodworks. You had Capo, you had Ninja Scalp, you had all the trolls on crypto Twitter and YouTube analysts say it's going to zero. You know, you have Garrett Soloway probably throwing a party for 10 to 12K Bitcoin. None of that is happening, okay? It's highly unlikely because there's strong support. This 36-day channel is finding, or Bitcoin is finding support on the bottom of this 36-day channel as evidenced by this strong accumulation schematic, okay? I did draw this channel yesterday during the live stream, but I did make a mistake in how I drew the channel. I can get into that a little later or during the next live stream. But prior to our getting to the bottom of this channel, I'll say that we were in this pattern and I thought that this was above the midline, but it was actually testing old support, lost support. So you lost this support right here and you retested it as new resistance there. Okay. And I just didn't read it because I had my channel misdrawn, but that's another topic for another day. So on the small time frame, we're looking good for continuation. We're looking good for a bounce off of this area around 22.9. Okay. Furthermore, you can see that it's not just Bitcoin, right? We use in cryptocurrency, it's really fun. At this point in time, you can use altcoins, you can use other assets in the space as a bellwether for what Bitcoin is doing. And as you can see, looking at DYDX, looking at Litentry, there's some altcoins that have already completely recovered their losses from yesterday's massive crash. You'll have people believe that it was a massive crash. It was 5%, okay? And in a bull run, what constitutes a bull run? It's not higher highs and higher lows. I always say on this channel, a bull run is breaking key resistances and flipping them into support, doing that successively. Just like a bear market is breaking key support and flipping them successively into resistance. As you can see here, we came to support, we regained that loss from yesterday, and so there's nothing bearish about this, guys. There's nothing bearish. Going up and down, we're not going to do this here, but go up and down your favorite altcoins. You'll see on a higher time frame, they're all on support. They're all on major support levels. You do not want a short support, okay? All major support. You can see this really quickly. If you just go up and down your watch lists, your favorite altcoins are on major support, all right? Even Bunk, which is a new, very low cap altcoin, it's on major support, okay? So it's very likely that you're not only going to get a bounce in Bitcoin, but you're also going to get a bounce in the rest of the cryptocurrency market. Now, what else characterizes a bull run? It's the opposite of what you see in a bear market. What do you see in a bear market? When Bitcoin dumps, Bitcoin dominance rises. What does that mean? Okay, it essentially means that altcoins are bleeding against Bitcoin. Okay, Bitcoin dumps and Bitcoin dominance rises, meaning altcoins lose more than Bitcoin does. Bitcoin dumps 2%, altcoins dump 10 or 20% or something crazy, right? But you see the opposite is true right here. This is exactly what you see in a bull market where altcoins actually front run the trend. It's all about trend dynamics, okay? Bitcoin is the biggest player. It has the largest market cap, so it moves the slowest. Altcoins have smaller market caps. They front run the trend. So in a bear market, they go down faster, further. In a bull market, they do the opposite. They go up faster and further. Bitcoin dominance has dropped since yesterday's epic crash, okay? Epic mollywop of the cryptocurrency markets. As you can see here, if you have declining Bitcoin dominance, and it's been declining for quite some time, right? On the higher time frames and even the smaller time frames, then you can see that this is another data point that leads you, that should lead you to believe that we are indeed in a bull market where altcoins rally against Bitcoin, what we call an alt season. Okay, lastly, we will consider the macroeconomic factors. You guys always hear people talking about PCE, CPE, CPI, all that stuff. The economy's down. We're in a recession. There's no way this can be a tried and true bull run. This has to be a bear market rally. Guys, I'm an analyst of the charts, okay? So you're not going to see me talking about all of that, what, you know, Jerome Powell met and the basis increase in percentages of interest rates. I'm just going to look at the charts. And the measure of what the macroeconomic situation is, what the Fed is doing, what the all that stuff, China and Japan, all that stuff, all these countries, what their economies are doing, the measure of all that is the dollar currency index. That's all you have to do. Some people are confused and thinking, oh, stock market is correlated and this and that. No. Chart it. Trust but verify, okay? Do your own research. If the stock market is indeed correlated to Bitcoin and leads Bitcoin, then you should be able to see it on a chart. If not, you're not doing due diligence, my friend, okay? But if you look at the US dollar currency index, which you can track for the past decade to be almost perfectly inversely correlated to Bitcoin and most risk on assets, then you understand it's all about the dollar, the underlying asset. And this, my friends, is not in a vicious bull market like most amateur analysts believe, okay? They see this counter correction and they confuse it for the trend. Again, this is a counter correction. It goes up in three waves. That is corrective. Also, the telltale sign for this, And we're going to use indicators to corroborate this. But the fact that you're breaking this 500-day support level, okay? This is 500 days. You could see this trend line, not just a random line drawn, but massive data point, massive support, massive sort of confirmation that this data trend line is legitimate. The DXY lost this support in January, okay? And ever since, what do you know about losing strong support? You have to retest it as resistance. You have to do that. That's just a rule. One of the things that, you know, is always can always be counted on in technical analysis. So once we did that, what did we do? We retested it. That this is a process of retesting that the lost support of this 500-day support level, okay? That's all DXY is doing. That's all it's been doing for the past 4 weeks in February, okay? And now our indicators are even telling us that this trend, this rally back up to test this 500-day lost support as resistance is exhausted. Look on the daily time frame. Your stochastic RSI indicator is completely overbought, okay? Look on the weekly time frame. It's going to be completely overbought in about a day. On the 4-hourly time frame, what is it? It's completely overbought. It's printing strong bearish divergence. On the hourly time frame, completely overbought, crossed bearish. On the 15-minute time frame, even the small time frames, it's in overbought territory. So, guys, the dollar is bearish. You do not want to be bullish on the dollar. You want to sell the dollar. You want to buy risk assets. Consider that your main indicator for what the macroeconomic situation is, okay? And then you can form all your narratives around that. But this is essentially it, guys. This is why this drop yesterday was a sign of strength. You can expect Bitcoin to quickly recover, and not only recover, but eventually break the 25K level, okay? And start an epic bull run, okay? The bull run's already started, but it's really going to be made apparent, okay? Like I said a few live streams back, it's going to feel like a bull market after 25K. Guys, I hope you got value from this. Please like, share, and subscribe. Have a great weekend, and I'll see you on Monday. Bye.
The police, because they can't arrest me.
My money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat, you really have to see it. 6'2" in a compact.